Hello guys, welcome to Time and Work last video, which is revision series number 3, and we have already studied two revision series which were related with time and work. And in this particular series we are going to discuss about wages, or we are going to talk about efficiency. So guys, the difficulty level of this particular video is medium, so you can expect even difficult questions to be asked in your exam, because RBI CAT level exams, they consist of advanced level problems. However, I am dealing here with the concept and I am revising your concept. So once you understand particular concepts which are related with wages, you can very well solve any advanced kind of a question. So guys, let us start this session. We have 5 questions as usual, and you will be given 90 seconds to complete each of the question. First question is, Ramlal is renowned packager of fruits in Varanasi. He packs 70 mangoes or 56 guavas every day, working 7 hours per day. His wife also helps him. She packs 30 mangoes or 24 guavas, working 6 hours per day. Ramlal has to pack 3,300 mangoes and 2,400 guavas with the help of his wife. They work for 10 hours every alternate day, with his wife starting first. At the end, both earn rupees 12,600. What is the daily income of Ramlal and his wife? So guys, I'll give you the approach to solve this kind of a problem. We have two people. We have the first one is Ramlal and the second one is Ramlal's wife. So we have to find out in 1 hour how many mangoes can he pack and how many guavas can he pack. Similarly, we have to find out for the wife. So Ramlal is working for 7 hours per day, whereas his wife is working for 6 hours per day. So per day he is going to pack 70 divided by 7 mangoes and 56 divided by 7 guavas. Similarly, with his wife, you have to calculate how many they can pack. Then you have to calculate what is the number of mangoes that they can pack in 10 hours, which is in 1 day, for Ramlal as well as for his wife. Similarly, you have to find out how many guavas can they pack in 10 hours or in 1 day, for Ramlal and his wife. Then you have to calculate the number of days that are required. And finally, you have to find out the efficiency and in what ratio will this 12,600 be divided. So guys, your time starts now. Okay guys, your 90 seconds time has ended. So let us find out how many mangoes can Ramlal pack in 1 hour. So he is working for 7 hours per day. In 1 hour, he is going to pack 10 mangoes. And the number of guavas that he is going to pack is 56 divided by 7, which comes out as 8. And his wife, she is also helping him. So she is packing 30 mangoes and working for 6 hours. So she is going to pack 5 mangoes per hour, and 24 guavas, which means she is going to pack 4 guavas. Guys, from here itself, you can make out that the wife is working at half the efficiency of Ramlal. So she is going to get half of whatever Ramlal is getting. Now you have to calculate what are the number of mangoes that Ramlal and his wife are going to pack in one day, which is in 10 hours. So in 10 hours, Ramlal is going to pack 100 mangoes and 80 guavas. Similarly, his wife is going to pack 50 and 40 guavas. 50 mangoes and 40 guavas. So if at all I find out what is the number of mangoes packed by both of them, so his wife is going to work for one day, first day, and the second day Ramlal is working. So in 2 days total they are going to pack 150 mangoes and they are going to pack 120 guavas. Now we have total of 3300 mangoes. So how many per day are they going to take? So 3300 divided by 150 and you get the answer as 22, which means that the wife is going to work for 22 days packing mangoes and Ramlal is going to work 22 days packing mangoes together. Now how many days are they going to take to pack guavas? So we have 2400 divided by 120, because the total is 120 and that comes out as 20. So the wife is going to take 20 days to pack guavas and Ramlal is going to take 20 days to pack guavas. So together Ramlal is going to work individually for 42 days and his wife individually is going to work for 42 days. Now as I told you, Ramlal's efficiency, the ratio of Ramlal and his wife's efficiency comes out as 2:1. From here itself, you can see that the efficiency ratio comes out as 2:1. And both of them, they are working for 42 days. Correct? Now, always remember that the wage that they are going to get is directly proportional to their efficiency. So the wages that Ramlal is going to get is going to be 2x and his wife is going to be 1x. So total we have 3x equal to 12,600. So we get the value of x as 4200. So which means that Ramlal is going to get twice of 4200, which is 8400. And his wife is going to get 4200. But is this what the question is asking? No, the question is asking daily income. So we have to divide this by 42 for Ramlal. So the daily income comes out as, when you divide it by 42, so Ramlal is going to get rupees 200 every day and his wife is going to get 100 rupees every day. So all you have to know about wages is that wages are directly proportional to efficiency. More the efficient a person is, more he or she is going to earn. So with this, let us solve the next problem. Okay guys, let's get to the next problem. So here we have three laborers A, B and C were given a contract of rupees 750 for doing a certain work. All three together finished the work in 8 days. A and C together can do it in 1/3 days. The money will be divided in what ratio? This is another additional information which I forgot to mention in this question. So that is, B and C are together doing the job in 12 days. So this is an information which I left out by mistake. So B and C together do it in 12 days. So guys, in this particular problem, take the LCM of 12, 8 and 13:1:3. Whatever is the LCM that you get, 13:1:3 by the way is 40/3. So whatever is the LCM that you get, assume that that many number of parts need to be made. So what are the parts that A, B and C together can make in one day? Calculate that, which is nothing but the LCM divided by 8. Then what are the number of parts that B and C can together make? So that is nothing but LCM divided by 12. And what are the parts that A and C can together make in one day? So that is nothing but LCM divided by 40 into 3. You will get this answer. Solve it simultaneously. Find out how many parts can A make in one day, how many parts can B make in one day, and how many parts can C make in one day. That is going to be the ratio of their efficiencies. That is going to be A is to B is to C is going to be the ratio of the efficiencies. You already given the wages, and the wages directly proportional to the efficiency. So guys, I give you 90 seconds to solve this problem. So please do solve it. Your time starts now. Okay guys, now the time has ended, 90 seconds have ended. So the LCM of 8, 12 and 40 upon 3 comes out as 120. Now all I have to do is find out, assume that there are 120 parts to be produced. So A, B and C together, they are producing 120 parts in how many days? In 8 days. So in one day they are going to produce 120 divided by 8, which is 15 parts. Similarly, B and C, they are together taking 12 days to produce 120 parts. So in one day, they are going to do 10 parts. Similarly, A and C together, they are doing the work in 40 upon 3 days, which means in one day, they are going to manufacture 120 divided by 40 into 3, which comes out as 9 parts. So we have the value, find out how many parts A is going to manufacture. So you just put this in this particular equation, you get that A is going to manufacture 5 parts. 5 parts, and then you put this into this particular equation, you will have B, and B is going to manufacture 6 parts. Similarly, now you know A and B's value. So put it in this particular equation and you will get that C is going to manufacture 4 parts. So the efficiency is 5 is to 6 is to C is to 4. Now divide this in the ratio 5 is to 6 is to 4. So you will get each one's share. Now the question asks, the money will be divided in what ratio? So the correct answer is 5 is to 6 is to 4. The money is going to be divided in 5 is to 6 is to 4. But I want to find out for my own understanding what is the amount that each one is going to get. So all I do is divide 750 by the sum of 5 plus 6 plus 4, which comes out as 15. And I have to divide it into, and the answer comes as 50. So A is going to get 50 into 5 parts, which is 250. B is going to get 6 into 50 parts, which is 300 rupees. And C is going to get 4 into 50, which is 200 rupees. So this is the amount everybody is going to get. Now let us solve the third question. Aryan, Neeru and Gulia can do a piece of work. Aryan is 5 times efficient than Neeru and Gulia takes half the time taken by Neeru to complete the job all by herself. If 1200 are paid for doing the job, then the difference between Aryan and Gulia's share is what? So guys, here you are given the efficiency, Aryan, Neeru and Gulia. Assume that Neeru is taking, Neeru's efficiency is X, then you have Aryan's efficiency which is 5X because Aryan is 5 times efficient than Neeru. Now you have Gulia who is taking half the time by Neeru, which means that Gulia is twice as efficient than Neeru. So Gulia is 2X efficient. Now you already know the ratio of efficiencies of Aryan, Neeru and Gulia. And you have rupees 1200 to be distributed. So guys, this problem I've already solved it for you. It shouldn't take more than 30 seconds. So I'm just giving you the time of 30 seconds to solve it. Please solve. Your time starts now. Alright guys, the 30 second time has ended. So we have the ratio of efficiencies as 5 is to 1 is to 2. So we want rupees 1200 to be divided in this particular ratio. So I have to divide rupees 1200 into 8 units because 5 plus 1 plus 2 is 8. So the 1 unit value comes out as 150. A is going to get 5 into 150, which comes out as 750. B is going to get 150, that is Nelia is going to get 150. And Gulia is going to get 2 into 150, which is 300. The total must be equal to 1200, guys. This is a way to cross check. What is the difference between Aryan and Gulia? So the difference between Aryan and Gulia's share is 750 minus 300, which comes out as 450. So the right answer is 450. This one was an easy one. Let's go to the next problem. A and B contract to do work together for 300. A can alone do the work in 8 days. B can do it in 12 days. With the help of C, they finish it in 4 days. So use LCM method. A, B and 8, 12 and 4, the LCM comes out as 24. So assume that there are 24 units that need to be made. A can alone do in one day, can make 3 units. B can make 2 units in one day. And C and A plus B plus C together, they can make 6 units in a day. Find out the value of C. Find out the ratio of the efficiencies and divide 300 basis the ratio of the efficiencies. Guys, I'm going to give another 30 seconds to solve this problem and your time starts now. Okay guys, your 30 seconds time has ended. So the value of C comes out as 1. So the ratio of A, B and C's efficiencies is the number of units that they manufacture in one day, which comes out as 3 is to 2 is to 1. So we have to divide rupees 300 in the ratio 3 is to 2 is to 1. So 1 unit is going to be equal to rupees 300 divided by 3 plus 2 plus 1, which comes out as 6. So 300 divided by 6, we get 50. So each unit is worth 50 rupees. A is going to, we have to find the share of C. So C's share is 50. So the share of C is nothing but 50 rupees. We need not even calculate how much A and B are getting. Again, an easy one, guys. Let's move to the last question. A and B can do a work in 10 days and 15 days respectively. A and B can together do for 5 days and the remaining day work is done by C in 2 days. If they are paid 6,000 for this work, find the daily income of each. Guys, use the LCM method. I'm not going to solve this problem for you. I will be solving it after 1 minute ends. So your time of 60 seconds starts now. Okay guys, your time of 60 seconds has ended. So we have A, B and C, and A can do the work in 10 days, B can do it in 15 days, and together they are doing it in 5 days. And A and B are working together for 5 days and remaining work is done by C in 2 days. So if they are paid 6,000 for this work, we have to find the daily income of each. So A is going to do 1 upon 10th work in one day. B is going to do 1 upon 15th work in one day. So together they are working for 5 days. So in 5 days A is going to do one half of the work and B is going to do one third of the work. Now they are working along with C. The remaining work is done by C. So this is the amount of work that they do. And that is done by C in 2 days. So what is the remaining work? The remaining work is nothing but 1 minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3, which comes out as 1 by 6. So 1 by 6 is the remaining work that has to be done by C. But C is taking 2 days to do 1 by 6th work. So in 1 day, C is going to do 1 by 12th work. A is working for 5 days, B is working for 5 days, and C is doing 1 6th of the work. So C is doing 1 6th of the work and working for 2 days. So this is the amount of work that each everybody is doing. So A is doing half of the total work, so he'll get half of 6,000, which comes out as 3,000. B is going to get one third of 6,000, which is 2,000. And C is going to get 1/6 of 6,000, which is, or you can say he is going to get the remaining sum, which is 1,000 rupees. Now A is working for 5 days, so A is going to get 600 rupees per day. B is working for 5 days, so B is going to get 400 rupees per day. And C is working for 2 days, so he is going to get 500 rupees per day. So this one was also an easy problem, guys. I hope you all have understood what we have talked about, wages. With this problem, I am ending this video. I hope the fear about time and work is gone, because we've solved really good problems related with time and work. If at all you understood these problems, you will be able to solve any problem, be it easy or advanced. With this question, guys, I'm ending this video. Wish you all the best. Thank you so much.